You're breaking up with me. Why?
Your credit score is terrible.
I'm revoking your tanning privileges for the rest of the semester. Can we please talk about the giant elephant in the room?
Your sexuality.
I told you guys. We know. You've been berating us for the better part of an hour.
Wait, you're joking, right? I mean, bake sales are kind of bougie.
Well, you two were babysitting. Puck and I were sexting.
Sexting?
Sexy, texting. Seriously, what era are you from?
We just heard. Who told?
We assumed it was you.
Why would I do that?
To get back at Puck, aren't you guys dating?
Sex is not dating.
Did you see what Rachel was wearing today?
Oh, I know. She looked like Pippi Longstocking, but like Israeli.
Can I ask you guys something private?
Yes, you should move to Israel.
It's high time you've lost the big V. Everything about you screams virgin. You're about as sexy as a Cabbage Patch Kid. It's exhausting to look at you.
A roller rink? Weren't those outlawed in like 1981 for being totally lame?
I mean, it's just a mohawk, right? Still Puckasaurus.
Actually, I don't know if it's the missing mohawk or the whining, but I am totally not turned on by you right now. What difference does it make? Everyone knows that my job here is to look hot.
Enjoy it while you can, Wheezy. His hair's already starting to grow back.
I hated everyone in this club.
Can I just say that you are the hottest dentist I've ever seen?
Yeah, I get that all the time.
No, like seriously, you can totally drill me whenever.
Santana!
I think I might be better at brushing and flossing if I could see myself in the mirror.
There you go, Blue too.
Okay, listen, my dad's a doctor. And not a tooth doctor, a real one. He like went to college or something, which means I have a killer healthcare plan that pretty much pays for everything. So get up in my grill, cause Brits and I won't to get our anesthesia on.
I went with her and I had a Britney fantasy too. Although now that I'm thinking about it, I'm not really sure how our fantasies combined. That doesn't make any sense.
Well, Rachel, congratulations. Normally you dress like the fantasy of a perverted Japanese businessman with a very dark specific fetish, but I actually dig this look.
I, for one, wouldn't mind saying thanks.
Thanks for what? That I didn't come out a lizard baby?
Hey, everybody, I'm Sam. Sam, I am. And I don't like green eggs and ham.
Oh, wow. He has no game. Second of all, I'm not making out with you because I'm in love with you and want to sing about making lady babies. I'm only here because Puck's been in the slammer for about 12 hours now, and I'm like a lizard. I need something warm beneath me, or I can't digest my food.
Look, Wheezy, I realize I've tried to punch you a couple times, and sometimes when you're not looking, I put weird things in your food. I'm sorry. Have you been to Breadsticks? They are legally forbidden to stop bringing you breadsticks. One time I brought a wheelbarrow, and when the manager tried to stop me from filling it up, I called the corporate office and got her fired.
How can you do a duet by yourself? That's like vocal masturbation or something.
I don't mean to be a bitch.
Well, yeah, actually I do. But the only thing that you can give Brittany that she can't get somewhere else is super choice parking.
Sam and Quinn!
What? What? Screw that! I want my stick! Ooh, let it go! Let go!
There's no way I'm playing a transvestite in high heels and fishnets and wearing lipstick.
Why? Because that look was last season?
Well, you guys have a hole to fill and I'm just trying to help fill it.
Wanky.
Santana.
The a cappella choir from the all boys private school in Westerville, the Dalton Academy Warblers. Ooh. Yeah.
Okay, hold up. Like a million awesome gay jokes just popped into my head.
Wait, something's definitely wrong. Why isn't Rachel talking?
You should be our nation's president. Can I just say that this is what happens when people don't put out? If everyone just put out, we would have a winning football team.
In Mr. Schuster's absence, I'd like to go around and ask everyone what solos they'd like to hear me perform at sectionals.
All right, you know what? Let me in! Go ahead and go ahead!
I'm Finn Hudson. I'm quarterback of the football team.
I'm Rachel Berry, his loud, loud girlfriend.
You're so on my list, dwarf.
You are such a hypocrite.
Like you even know what that means.
It means that your boyfriend is full of crap, hobbit.
Where's Puck? I haven't seen him since yesterday, and I need him to get me a churro.
Nobody tells you anything because A, you're a blabbermouth, and B, we all just pretend to like you.
And the ornaments?
The guy who lives next door finally killed off his elderly mother. When they carted him off, they left the house, like, wide open, so I think she was a holiday hoarder.
I want bling. I can't be any more specific than that. Okay, wait, hold up. Please tell me that is a roll of certs in your pocket.
The girls are gonna sell their hair.
You can't do that.
I know, it's cool. Most of this isn't mine anyway.
You know what it's about.
Yeah, I know what it's about. Life freaking sucks.
I've kissed Finn, and can I just say, not worth a buck. I would, however, pay $100 to jiggle one of his man boobs.
Do you ever get tired of tearing other people down?
No, not really.
Oh, please. You guys love me. I keep it real, and I'm hilarious.
Because I just try to be really, really honest with people when I think that they suck, you know?
Yeah.
They don't guess it.
Look, you made your point. I'm sort of a bitch, but I'm willing to change. I won't tell Lauren to look out for poachers who might mistake her for the endangered white rhino.
Hello, Well, Lauren, you are a beautiful person.
Thank you.
Now get out of my way, please, afore as I end you.
You don't want to push me.
Oh, but see, I sort of do. I'm from a part of town called Lima Heights Adjacent. You know where that is, Poppin' Fresh? It's on the wrong side of the tracks. Ugh, gross. How is this possible? I'm the hottest piece of action at this school, and here I am on Valentine's, single. Ugh, whatever. I'll just marry an NFL player. They're super reliable. Holy sweet hell. They're fooling around. I know what cheating looks like. I do it all the time. I've had mono so many times it turned into stereo.
There's no secret that Coach Sylvester has taken her licks.
I mean, just wanky. I mean, my carousel horse sweater should make me look like an institutionalized toddler, but no. I look hot and smart. I feel like Michelle Obama. Despite the fact that your mouth-to-face ratio is, like, way off, you still somehow manage to be cute. But make no mistake, every time you open your humongous mouth to do an impression or moisten an enormous stamp for a lazy giant, you take one step closer to everyone seeing that you are actually a dork. Which is where I come in. I hereby offer my services as a mistress. I wants on them froggy lips, and I wants on them now. I know you're as dumb as a bag of wet hair, but you know in your heart she's lying. That gumball story was insane. You're choosing to believe it so you can still be with her. But consider my offer. Not only am I giving you full visitation rights to the set of rambunctious twins that live on my ribcage, you get the chance to show that pastry bag Finn that he can't mess with Sam Evans. And not just because you can unlock your humongous jaw and swallow him whole like a python.
We need an undisputable advantage.
Check out Dwarf Diane Warren.
You're going, right?
Only if there's liquor, because a Rachel Berry party is not something I can do sober.
But it's Alcohol Awareness Week.
Precisely. And I am aware of how much fun alcohol is.
You like her more than me! She's blonde and awesome and so smart! Admit it! Just admit it! No, excuse me!
You know what? A reminder? I owned that guppy mouth. Those shoddy Aerosmith lips belonged to me, so...
You know what this is not? Hey, honeys? It's not a Big Red commercial. No me gusta.
I've been dry heaving all weekend. When my mother asked what the sound was, I said that I was practicing bird calls.
Please don't tell anyone, okay? Especially Artie.
Yeah, sure. Your secret's safe with... Oh my God, Brittany's pregnant.
Sexy.
I really hope that's not one of the requirements for regionals, because with Barry in those tights, we don't stand a chance. I'm not interested in any labels. Unless it's on something I shoplift.
I made out with a mannequin. I even had a sex dream about a shrub that was just in the shape of a person.
We should write original songs for regionals.
All those in favor of voting Rachel down a second time?
All I know is you blew me off. To be with Stubbles, my cripple pants.
Guppy face. Trouty mouth. Lips look where you come from in the south. Group of mouth, froggy lips. I love sucking on those salamander.
I could just say a few words.
Sure.
And here she goes, making me regret voting for her.
We won regionals for the first time since dinosaurs roamed the planet, and I still got a freaking cherry icy facial. First of all, anything you do became my business when you decided to toss that slushy up in my grill.
I think I can take a couple of queers and a girl.
Okay.
See, here's what's gonna go down. Two choices. You stay here and I crack one of your nuts, right or left, that's your choice. Or you walk away and live to be a douchebag another day. Oh, and also, I have razor blades hidden in my hair. Mm-hmm. Tons. Just all up in there. I hear that Rachel's got a bit of a schnoz. I mean, I wouldn't know, because like Medusa, I try to avoid eye contact with her. But can we all just stop lying about how there aren't things that we wouldn't change about ourselves? I mean, I'm sure that Sam's been at the doctor's office and rifled through pamphlets on mouth reduction. I'll bet Artie's thought about getting his legs removed since he's not really using them anyways. And I'm definitely sure that Tina's looked into getting an eye de-slanting. It's extraordinarily racist. I'm keeping it real.
I like the way I look.
Oh, please. You have weird, puffy pyramid nipples. They look like they're filled with custard. You could dust them with powdered sugar and they could pass for some sort of dessert. Look, maybe Rachel's fine with having an enormous beak. Maybe she needed to crack hard seeds. I'm a closet lesbian and a judgmental bitch.
I've got a gay. Go. Go, I've got
to
go.
First of all, I saw you checking out Sam's ass the other day. You know, you really need to be more careful with your layering.
I didn't. I was just seeing what jeans he was wearing.
Like that's any less gay. Why don't you just settle down and let Auntie Tana here tell you a little story. It's about you. You're what we call a late-in-life gay. You're going to stay in the closet, get married, get drunk to have relations with your wife, have a couple kids, maybe become a state senator or a deacon, and then get caught in the men's room tapping your foot with some page. And you know what? I accept that about you. Look, I'm not ready to start eating jicama or get a flat top yet either. Maybe in junior college. Only straight I am a straight-up bitch.
Got mine. What? This is perfect. Legend has it that when I came out of my mother, I told the nurse she was fat.
What about him?
He's just furniture.
You know, I blame Sam for all of this. And Rachel, too, I blame her.
What did I do?
I'm sure you did something.
No gay protests or rainbow flags being lit on fire down this way.
Are you finished talking?
Yeah.
When you're finished talking, you should say over.
How could my running mate win and I didn't? I mean, just because I hate everybody doesn't mean they have to hate me, too.
As soon as we get to New York, I'm bailing to live in a lesbian colony. Or Tribeca.
Once that I was a lesbian, I mean, they must have. Do I smell like a golf course?
Thanks so much for coming in.
Wait, that's all you have to say? You spent the entire performance scribbling notes.
Well, if you really must know, I was simply writing down that I don't think that your performance went very deep into the emotional truth of the song.
Oh, is that so? Well, I happen to have some feedback for you.
Thanks, Santana. That's all we'll need.
I'm about to go all Lima Heights.
Thank you.
Oh, Mr. Shio, thank God you're here to put these trolls out of their misery. Can you just announce my win so that I can get on with teasing the loser?
And how do you get that raspiness?
So nice. I smoke cigars.
Quinn, quit hogging the bathroom. I need to re-pencil my eyebrows on.
So pissed.
Do you think this voodoo doll looks enough like Rachel Berry to actually work?
Nah. See, let me tell you how it is gonna be, if I may. When I look at a person, I don't see someone who looks a certain way or has this or that amount of chromosomes. I just see someone who I may or may not have to destroy. So if you ever tell me what to do, I will end you.
I have pepperoni in my bra.
Those are your nipples.
I wanted something toned down.
This is toned down. In the original, the unicorn was riding you.
Why are you babying her? I mean, she can't do three steps without puking because she ate a Quiznos before she showed up in this joint.
Nice blouse, Hummel. Really brings out the color of your pink eye. And yeah, Kurt looks like Jimmy Fallon's butch daughter, but a vote for him would only empower yet another Frankenbeans.
You know what, girl Trang? If you cry every time someone gets a hangnail, it kind of starts to lose its effect. Do not even think about talking for the next 30 seconds, okay? Nod so I know you understand me. Good. Here's the deal, pixie boy. You've got a crush on my girl, Brittany. I understand. She's beautiful, she's innocent, she's everything that's good in this miserable, stinking world. Do you agree? Nod. Good. Also, she thinks you're a sprightly, green, mythological creature. But I know you're a potato-eating poser. But since Brittany likes having a pet Irish, I'm not gonna explode you. Here's what's gonna go down. Leprechaun, starring a young Jen Aniston, is my favorite movie. It learned me two things. One, leprechauns like fixing shoe buckles because they're gay. And two, they grant wishes. So you're gonna grant me a wish. That's right, double-stuffed, fatty, gassy McGravy pants. We are just one big, happy, happy family.
Santana, stay out of this.
You are such a bacon-wrapped, bug-eyed hypocrite. It's freaking hilarious how jealous of Blaine you are. Every time he opens his dreamboat acapella mouth, you're just itching to kick him right in the warblers. Let me write you a reality check, Richie bitch. I've seen what you can do, and what you can do is stand in the back, sway, and sing very, very quietly.
If Rachel wants my sloppy seconds, she should at least know the truth. Look, it was like being smothered by a sweaty, out-of-breath sack of potatoes that someone soaked in body spray.
Oh, and guys,
Hurry up. Go get some moist towels. We have to keep Finn wet before we can roll him back in the sea. And Rachel, your mustache is thicker than a Middle Eastern dictator's.
That is the lamest thing I didn't understand a word of.
Not one word.
Is that really all that you can come up with? You seriously think that you can out-insult me? I'm from Lima Heights. I was raised on insults. Tell me abuela put me to sleep at night, and she is not a nice lady. You know, she tried to sell me once, and it wasn't until I got to kindergarten that I learned my name wasn't Garbage Face. What's on, Pillsbury Doter? Hey, Tubbs. Can I talk to you for a second?
Hey, listen here. You can't make fun of Finn anymore.
Shut your potato hole. I'm here to apologize. Rachel's right. I haven't been fair to you. You're not fat. I should know. I slept with you. I mean, at some point, I must have liked that you look like a taco addict who's had one too many back alley liposuctions.
Whoa.
Please stick a sock in it or ship yourself back to Scotland. I'm trying to apologize to Lumps the Clown. I am sorry, Finn. I mean, really, I'm sorry that the new directions are going to get crushed by the Trouble Tones. I'm also sorry that you have no talent. Sorry that you sing like you're getting your prostate checked, and you dance like you've been asleep for years, and someone just woke you up. Have fun riding on Rachel's coattails for the rest of your life. Although, you know what? I would just watch out for her come holiday time if I were him, because if I were her, I'd stick a stent in one of those boobs and let the Finn blubber light the Hanukkah lamp for 8 magical nights.
I think you need to stop making fun of Finn. You're being really harsh.
Manatees have really thick skin. This is garbage. Hamburglar Finn is fine.
Santana, we're worried about you.
Worry about yourself, fetus face.
Santana, Kurt and I have a song we like to sing to each other in the car, and we want to sing that for you right now.
Well, there's nothing I'd love more than having two pretty ponies serenade me. I think we'd get further staging a Jellervention for Blaine than singing Lady Muse.
If you would just stop being so defensive.
I'm trying, but your hideous bow ties are provoking. Oh, well, thanks, but that's never going to happen. I'd miss me too much.
Just heard the news that Trouty Mouth is back in town.
I've been keeping a notebook just in case this day ever came. Welcome back, Lisa Renna. I've missed you so much since your family packed their bags, loaded them in your mouth, and skipped town. Can't tell you how many times I've wanted to enjoy a crisp pickle, but couldn't find anyone to suck the lid off the jar. I assume you've been working as a baby polisher where young mothers place their infants' heads in your mouth to get back that newborn shine. So glad you're back. I haven't seen a smile that big since a claymation abominable snowman got his teeth pulled by that little gay elf dentist. Love, Santana.
That is incredibly rude, Santana.
We're being nice. It would be rude if I followed you around and every time you took a step, I played a note on a tuba. It was that damn Trouty Mouth. Even I felt a little something in my lady loins when he did that magic sex dance.
Gosh, that song was so depressing. I may actually be dead right now.
It's not like this is the first time I've ever proposed.
Oh, yeah? How did that marriage work out for you? I mean, what was your big move then? A jumbotron that said, hey, Terry, I want to make a fake baby with you.
I just wanted to say that I thought that you blew that song out of the water and totally nailed the assignment. Oh, no, wait a second. The assignment wasn't make everything about Rachel Berry and force everyone to watch, was it? I'd throw the smoke on your face, but it's not nearly scalding enough.
Well, today's your lucky day because Auntie Snakes just arrived on the Bitchtown Express. Now, my suggestion is that we drag him bound and gagged to a tattoo parlor for a tramp stamp that reads tips appreciated or congratulations, you're my 1,000th customer.
You may look like the villain out of a cheesy 80s high school movie, but you should know that I am fully prepared to go all Danny LaRusso on your ass.
No, we're not doing that.
Why? Kurt, this isn't violent. This is clever. I taped it to my underboob. If Kurt would have taped this to his junk, I would have never heard the end of it. We would have had a whole week of songs about it.
Duende?
Ugh, it means dwarf, you ass.
Now, I realized when I chose Becky as co-captain for the Cheerios, I might have rubbed you the wrong way.
Wanky.
It's possibly derailing my bid for tenure just when I'm trying to have a baby.
A baby? With whose vagina? Why don't you just dress up as the Taco Bell Chihuahua and bark the theme song to Dora the Explorer? Of that? Our lips barely even grazed. And by the way, did you get any complaints about that hideous display that started at 12:17 p.m. and lasted for several uncomfortable minutes? Let me break it down for you. From one bitch to another.
How about you save the lecture for the theater nerds that are going to starve in New York while desperately trying to tap dance their way into the course of Godspell? No offense, Gay Barry. And everyone can stop their hating because you all want to be famous too. The only difference is that I am 1,000% sure that I'm actually going to be famous. Just like I'm 1,000% sure that our man-child piano player keeps a petite Eurasian locked in a trunk underneath his bed. Sorry, Chang.
Why is everyone staring at me like I'm Finn and I just want a butter-eating competition? Oh, crap. I think I just realized I'm gonna miss you. Oh, God. Say something irritating so I can get the taste of this out of my head, please.
What? That makes no sense.
Shut it, Richard Simmons. Yes, Quinn's my homegirl, but I don't trust her. And you know she doesn't trust me. How is everyone welcome when this is clearly just a party for you and the two gay Winklevi twins?
Shouldn't we be in some sort of grinding union?
Wanky.
Kurt and I are gay and Mercedes is black, so kicking us out would be a hate crime.
I am strangely turned on right now.
Hey, I don't want to hear
any of this, we can't do it without her. Because guess what? We don't have a choice. So be warned. If you are not giving this everything you've got, I will go all Lima Heights on your sorry asses.
Listen to yourselves.
I know. I'm sorry. I always go to the yelling place. I have rage.
What is this crap?
I mean, I'm not jealous. I just think that it's insane that all Porcelain had to do to get an internship with Vogue.com is take photos of every ridiculous outfit he's ever paired with a Cossack hat and a see-through raincoat and then show up at an interview where he is lauded as a visionary because his jod purse happened to match his riding crop.
Hi, I have a question. What the hell are you talking about?
I was born to play this role. I've known it by heart since I was one already. Come on.
You're so funny and self-deprecating. We're so much alike.
Wanky. Okay, Lumps, let me just say out loud what everyone here is thinking. You finally got an okay haircut. You're not doing that annoying half smirk as much as you used to, but you're still an idiot. No one in this room can tackle a massive dance number except for Britt. And that includes your little hand jive. That to me looked more like a hand jive.
Is there any way?
Why are you going through my back?
It's all part of being a mentor. Topless is as nude as anyone is ever going to want to see.
Some women find it empowering to be naked on film.
Yes, but not in a student film that is probably about someone's grandma with Alzheimer's.
Trotty Mouth inspired me to try my hand at songwriting. Group of mouth. Now Sam gave me...
Listen up, Lipsy McChapstick. Everyone thought that I was being a bitch when all I was doing was being brutally honest with people. I'm so over this, and it hasn't even started yet. I'm clearly the hottest bitch in this lousy joint, but I'm all alone, stuck here sitting with you.
Do you want me to slap you again?
I hate weddings. And I hate Valentine's Day. They were invented by breeders to sell cheap chocolate and false hope.
Like Eli Roth decided to make a gay horror movie, and this is the scene right before we all eat each other. So where are you from, Doctor Who?
England. Do you know Essex?
No, I never heard of it.
Santana, did you go through our DVD collection?
I sure did. Knocked Up, Hilarity, Rosemary's Baby, that's obviously Lady Hummel's, and She's Having a Baby.
I thought that you were crying because you and Blaine used to talk about how this was your dream to sing this song to each other at your wedding. Did we? Yeah. I remember you telling me that singing this song to someone was a more intimate act than sex. When I first met him, totally thought he was weird. He smelled all talcumy like a Cabbage Patch doll. And then he said that I wasn't a real New Yorker until I had my first makeover, and I was like, what does that even mean? Like, who are you? I said, so what if he's completely hairless and made out of plastic? I'm gonna look past the fact that he probably has a disgusting porn star landing strip. I'm gonna give Lars and the Real Boy one more chance. Who cares if he's terrified of banks? Because if I were made out of plastic, I'd be scared of a lot of things too. Open flames, barbecues. I see one more scene of Satine coughing up blood into a handkerchief. I'm gonna start coughing up blood into a handkerchief. Okay. New York may be disgusting, especially when it's covered in gray, nasty snow, and the people may be horrible and rude, and some smelly homeless man in pee-stained tidy-whities might have groped me on the subway and then asked me for a dollar. But I got to say, I finally feel like I have found my people. Where are the Hardy Boys investigating the mystery of God? Could you be any more annoying? And Pablo Escobar, did he ever come home? Brody is in the shower, where he will be for the next hour scrubbing the drug shame off of his frictionless body.
Just don't get too close, girls, unless you're immune to the herbs.
Listen, twins, let me tell you something. I've known you both for years, and I don't like either of you 90% of the time. In fact, your wide-eyed, keen-painting approach of life makes my teeth hurt and my breasts ache with rage.
Wow, that sounds really not romantic and also very, very gay.
Is that why he left, huh? Did he finally admit to having a boyfriend on the side?
Maybe a mascara mustache for Lady Hummel, which would probably be the only facial hair he's ever had. Or we could do that stick his hand in warm water, make him wet the bed trick. Lady's choice.
If you ever tell anyone about this, I have no ethical problems with Hummelside.
With a little TLC and three clicks from Kurt's ruby slippers, this bad boy would be salvageable. All right, you know what, Rachel? If you are still obsessing over what you're going to sing at your funny girl callback, may I suggest your best jam ever? Run, Joy, run.
And guess who gets to attend? They just volunteer a few short hours.
Anne Hathaway.
It's us.
Are you serious? And just when you thought it couldn't get any gayer, it does.
You're late.
I'd like to make an entrance. And if we're really going to talk about late, can you say something to Grant?
Sit.
I'm sorry, did hell just freeze over, or did you just white chocolate butt dial me?
It's about Britney.
Obviously.
Okay, she broke up with me.
Inevitably. Okay, and are we sure it's not just Britney 3.0 Week in Glee Club? You are not backing out. I basically had to show Gunther my left side boob to get you this job. Let's face it, there are good kinds of yeast and bad kinds of yeast. But bad yeast goes scat with yeast-a-stat.
burns an itch or a thing of the past. And Yeastostat's 7 easy step application makes feeling fresh a breeze. I like yeast in my bagel, but not in my muffin.
Did you hear the news? Let's have a chat. That yeast goes with Yeastostat.
I'm free. No, no, help me, okay? I'm getting that stinky panic sweat under my boots.
You are not playing the end of the lesbian matchmaker.
I guess those contracts I signed for those commercials said that I waived my right to residuals in exchange for a lifetime supply of Yeastostat. Though I don't know whose toxic vagina would need that much of that stuff. I mean, if you're producing that much yeast, you should probably start a bakery. Isn't it amazing how life seems so easy when you just don't give a fart? I mean, look at this. Hummel is getting married. Barry is just full of confidence, and I finally have a girlfriend who I don't have to worry about straying for penis. Gunther, that's my yeast system. What the hell?
I don't care for your attitude.
Well, I don't give a hot, wet monkey's ass what you care for. I know that Finn had his doubts about God, but I am convinced that Squishy Teats is up in heaven right now, plopped down next to his new best friend, Fat Elvis, helping themselves to a picnic of baby back ribs smothered in butterscotch pudding and tater tot grease. So, this is for you, Hudson. Awesome. No mangoose.
Santana.
What did you expect? No one's gonna try out for a band that doesn't even have a name. Although I came up with an amazing one.
Okay, we are not naming the band the Apocalypstics, okay? I'm manifesting the perfect name, all right? It takes time.
Yeah, and in the meantime, no one signs up. I'm sorry, would you mind just stepping outside for a moment while I bitch slap some sense into my friend?
What are you guys doing?
Beating our heads up against the wall trying to come up with a name for our band that pleases the queen.
Okay, seriously, I'm not going to be able to survive if you and your hag Barry are going to be tickling those ivories, belting out gay hits from Rent and Showboat all day.
Well, Merry Christmas, Lady Hummel. Now you can relive all of your Jeffrey Dahmer fantasies in the privacy of your own home.
It is exhausting playing a slutty elf.
No, no, you play Mrs. Claus, Lady Hummel. You were born to play Mrs. Claus and Mrs. Butterworth and Bea Arthur and Barbara Bush.
And what would you like for Christmas?
I want a Dot Nick Stephens time for your checkup doll.
Oh, that's so cute.
Well, that sounds a little molesty. I mean, I didn't start playing doctor till I was 9. We'll see what I can do.
I think that somebody needs to freeze the fat for Christmas because somebody weighs more than Mrs. Claus.
Oh, whoa, stop right there. You look a little Jewish, right, Rachel?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Bye. I think he pooped in his pants.
I want a Kinder College Learning laptop.
Why don't we just get you an iPad? You can't even get porn on whatever you just asked me for.
Hey, how's it going?
You look exactly like a young Brittany S. Pierce, doesn't she? Brittany is my ex-girlfriend, and she just dumped me, which is why I'm even here and why I have this job, and we're lesbians, you know? And, like, I'd never
okay,
been...
Okay, like great job.
What would you like for Christmas? Oh, nope. You know what? I think that you should ask Santa to get your daddy a job with some dental benefits because your grill is freaking jacked up. Do you see? I think that Mrs. Claus needs a break. This is going well, right?
Okay, listen. Even I'll admit that my girl-loving vagina is feeling a little jingle go from you, but we don't need your help.
The last time I felt like this was when I was roofied at Lilith Fair.
I need this job. I'm saving up to buy a noose to hang myself with.
Love for things to get physical. I will hit you so hard that you won't be able to wake up until you're old enough to be funny, lady.
Lady Hummel, come here. I need your tiny, delicate, elfin-like fingers to help me fasten this weed. In the beginning, it's all sunshine and giggles and stickers. And then the second that you want the same thing as her, a dark cloud comes over her whiskery little chin. And she will chew you up and spit you out like a Jewish Hillary Clinton.
I'm actually just here to get her sheet music. Do you know where she keeps it?
Upper butt. Well, maybe you should take that as a sign of your horrible personality disorder.
Hi, Santana Lopez. Word on the street is that you're old money.
I'm a lesbian, but totally into that. She dyed her hair pink. She got a Ryan Seacrest tattoo. And then lit a purple piano on fire.
See, you've all met Rachel, okay? But I live with her. Let me tell you what it's like to share a bathroom with this stubby, undergrown little cretin. Someone in that apartment shaves their face and leaves their stubble in the sink. And we all know it ain't Kurt, so do the math. No, you know what? Go ahead, please. Because if I don't express my venom at least once a day, I get constipated.
I'd rather do hard with you than easy with somebody else.
Wanky.
Actually, we did it all over your apartment.
Oh.
And if I were you, I'd put something down on that couch before I sat on it.
No, 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 no. Open it.
Come on.
Open it. I'm cold. Can you open it?
Rachel.
Give me this. I don't mind being the bearer of bad news.
I know funny girl's dark.
Dark as in there are no performances, or dark as in it's kind of a downer. You don't need a publicist when you've got Snicks on your side. If there's one thing I know about, it's cultivating an image. In high school, I was a huge bitch, but also most popular. I was voted best shoulder to cry on and most likely to poison someone.
Did you know that New York City shelters are the most overpopulated in the state?
What? No, I didn't know that. That's such a shame.
These two are wearing underwear. As much as I would love to watch Homokyo and the geriatric puppets put on a depressing sub-community theater show, my motto is, if I can make Barry work, I can do anything.
Oh, no. No. I think I've made a mistake.
Jagged Little Tapestry.
Oh, look. Finally, some songs about Rachel's hair extension.
Kurt, can I have a word with you?
Oh, I'm gonna go.
No, you need a rough stay. Kurt, I took what you said to heart, and I thought long and hard about it, and it occurred to me that you may have a point. Okay, maybe Brittany and I are too young to get married. I mean, after all, that's why it didn't work out with you and Blaine, right? Or maybe it didn't work out because you're a judgmental little geronophile with a mouth like cat's ass. Maybe Blaine got tired of hearing a shrill, self-aggrandizing lecture about how you felt the two of you were at the very apex of the gay rights movement every time you so much as cooked macaroni and cheese together or farted. Maybe Blaine didn't want to be with someone who looks like they just removed their top row of dentures every time they smile, or someone who doesn't dress like an extra out of one of Andy Dick's more elaborate wet dreams. Maybe Blaine grew weary of dating a breathier, more feminine Quinn Fabray. Maybe he finally got freaked out by your strange obsession with old people that causes you to skulk around nursing homes like one of those cats that can smell cancer. Maybe he got tired of watching you drape yourself on every piano you happen past to entertain exactly no one with, say, some song that Judy Garland choked on her tongue in the middle of, or some sassy old Broadway standard made famous by another dead alcoholic crone. Maybe Blaine woke up one day and said, you know what? I don't want to marry a sexless, self-centered baton twirler. Maybe I need someone who knows more than three dance moves. The finger wag, the shoulder shimmy, and the one where you pretend to twirl two invisible rainbow-colored ribbons attached to your hips. So you know what? Maybe that's why it didn't work out. Maybe it has nothing to do with me and Brittany. Maybe it's just that you are utterly, utterly intolerable. Maybe that has something to do with it. Last I heard, she was on Facebook posting about her diverticulitis, trolling for sympathy.
See, it's even more important. She's sick.
No, Britt, she can't poop, and I don't think that's going to kill her.
Let's go humor a bunch of tone-deaf losers by acting surprised when we walk in this auditorium.
Deal.
Wait. Okay, hold up. No me gusta. Why is Sue on the list?
I can't believe it's the same anniversary now.
I can't. Wait, hold up. What was that?